Hi guys, this is Khan, and today we are going to make British Petroleum logo. And why I selected this logo, because it is very beautiful, one thing, and second thing that it will help us to understand few of the options of Adobe Illustrator. So let's start. First of all, go to View menu and select this Smart Guides. Make sure this Smart Guide should be ticked or turned on. Then go to this one and select Printing and Proofing from here, so that you will get these options here, so that it will become very easy for you to follow the steps I am doing. So let's start. But before that, please like and subscribe this channel, because it took me the whole one day to decide that what is the easiest way to make this logo. So I deserve a like and subscribe in the end of this video. Thanks guys in advance. So let's start. First of all, go to here in the tools, select this ellipse tool, press and hold, and you will find the ellipse tool here. Click here. In the width, enter 40 pixel and height 40. Press OK. You will get a circle here, but you need another one. So again click here, and you will again this see, now you have got two circles. What you have to do, drag this circle close to this one, so that this line should be touching the center of this one. How? The smart guides will help you. So start dragging, and you will find that this one like intersect. So both the circles are close to each other. In case if they are not aligned properly, so you can select this vertical align center. Now go to transform. In the transform, select Pathfinder. Select the white. Now come here, right click here, ungroup this one. So basically we have divided the shape into three, and we need the center one. We'll drag it out, select it and drag it out, and we don't need this one, so we'll delete it. So basically this is the first pattern, and we will be using this pattern to make this shape. Now select the ellipse tool again, because we need one circle, the same size, that's why I selected this one. Now select this one, and we need to change the height and width of this one. Select width 40 and height 100. Press enter, and you will get this one circle. Now we want this petal to rotate around this object, so we will place this one on this circle, this petal on this circle, so that this point should be touching the center of this one. And when you drag with the help of your mouse, select it and drag it, and see the center is written here. As soon as you will get the center or intersect, see the shape is in the center of this one. Okay, intersect is here. Now select this shape, and we have to rotate these petals around this one. With the same petal, we need to 18 copies, because 18 petals are there around this one. Okay. So select this one, select rotate tool, and bring your cursor at the center of this one. This intersect should be here. See, as soon as you get the intersect here, now press and hold Alt key, and press left mouse key, and you will get this dialog box. Click on preview, so that you will have some idea that how we are receiving the petals here. 20 is okay, but in case if you need to do this thing again with some other shapes, so I will tell you how to do it. If you need to rotate a shape around a circle, so you must have the numbers that how many objects you want. Like we need 18 petals around this one. So what we'll do, 360, that is the total degree of a circle, divided by 18, and just copy it. We have got 2. Now press and hold Ctrl key and press D. See, the copy of this object is here, and how many minis? We 1, 2, 3 we have got, and 18 minis. So I'll count it and repeat the same. Control D. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Now, select them all. Go to Pathfinder and select divide. Now, what I'll select? I'll select zoom tool so that I can zoom this flower and select different of these parts. You can start with the ungroup, select them individually, or you can use the shape builder tool that we are going to use now. See, select them one by one so they become shape, or even start with the center circle and then select them like this so that it will become one shape. This is the first flower. We need four flowers, so this is the first one, the white one, and this is our shape. Now click here, click back here, and drag this one out. This is the white one. You see, we need four flowers. One white, second one yellow, third one yellow but 50% opacity. The third, fourth one is green. So the first one is ready, white one. You can select the color white here and white here. Or you can do aquarelle, but I'm doing it now. Then select the whole shape again. This one, select this whole shape again. Select the shape builder tool. Select them. This is the first shape, and then these are petals of the second layer. But keep in mind that it should be, the shape should be like this. Don't include the other ones. This is, if you want, then you can take them as well, but it doesn't matter if you don't need it. This is our second shape. Now select them all again. Shape builder tool. This one, and then the next layer of petals. If you want to include them, you can select them as well. If you want, like this. This one. Okay. Now click here, selection tool, and drag this one out. This is the final layer of petals. You can unite them, you can even merge them, unite them again, and then you'll get this shape. And the color for this one, it should be green. First select CMYK green, and then just click here, and then bring the mouse here, and you will see hold shift key to bring up alternate color UI. So I will hold the shift key, press left mouse key button, and here RGB I have got. It's okay, but here I need 0. So you will get the exact green color of the large star. And now what we need to select them all. Lines we don't need. Okay. And this one, I need opacity 50%. See, this one and this. Okay. Now select them all and then align them in the center from here, horizontally and vertically. See, we have got the order of this one. We have to bring it to the front and then this one to the front. Let's say yes. Yep. Now select them all, align them center like this. So that's our shape ready. Guys, please like and subscribe. And in case if you want to make any logo, just let me know in the comment section and I will make that logo for you. Thank you much, guys. Thank you much for watching.